This meant that in my time as a controller, there were over 100 plugging applications every week from publishers and record companies seeking appointments. The producers would never have time to listen to all the singles and albums issued if there was a plugger knocking on the door every 5 minutes, so there had to be access restrictions. There was only so much needle time, and this army of pluggers would resort to a range of tactics to draw producers and DJs' attention to their particular item. Here are a few pluggers' stories. Richard Evans. Richard is a Nottingham lad who started at Decca and became promotion boss of Epic Records and later as an independent. He was the source of much fun and laughter in our world. This is what he said. You have to remember that many of the producers were going to lunch in some of the finest restaurants in London, often taken in a limousine like royalty. To make a difference, as a plugger you had to make a noise, stand out from the others. There were perhaps 60 or 70 new singles every week coming out, and Radio 1 was only adding a small number of those to its playlist, so it wasn't hard if the artist was well known, but if it was unknown, you had to make a distinctive statement. One of the more intelligent pluggers was Alan James, and he told me, "I found it degrading, all that queuing to see producers, and I refused to do it." Later, when the appointment system was introduced, it was a little better, but I knew it took time, and my first lesson as a plugger was that until you knew the producers well, and they knew you, you couldn't break through that barrier. Once a relationship had been established, then you were aware of the areas where they might be flexible. It was a matter of learning how each individual producer approached his job.